The international meeting, Probiotics, Prebiotics and New Foods, has been held once every 2 years over the past 2 decades at the prestigious Pontificia Urbaniana University in Rome. The meeting was first created and has developed over the years out of the belief, now widely accepted and stated in literature, about the significant influence of microbiota on the health of the host. Numerous recent metagenomic studies have provided us with information on the composition of microbiota in healthy and sick individuals. A high diversity of microbiota is generally held to be associated with a healthy state, a loss in such diversity with an illness. Over 25 illnesses have been related to an altered microbiota state. Over the years, the main topics of the meeting, namely probiotics and prebiotics, have been extended to cover related topics that have been the subject of studies, researches and arguments such as nutraceuticals and botanicals. In 2019, the meeting continued to look at all those legislative and regulatory aspects that are of great interest to the research and industrial worlds. In the 10th edition, IPA Europe has been the training partner, while Fedrosaurus was the partner representing national industry. Previous editions have been attended by over 5,000 researchers from all over the world, presenting an interesting range of geographic representation from a social point of view. Our meetings have been attended by GPs, clinicians, microbiologists, biologists, virologists, veterinary surgeons, dietitians, nutritionists, and researchers in general, as well as representatives of industry from the areas of marketing, legal aspects, R&D, and so on. In light of this growing interest from industry, greater space was given in the 2019 edition to meetings between research and industry, business to business. From each edition of the meeting, 120 abstracts were selected, many of which published with meeting proceedings as a supplement to a journal having an excellent IF. Over the past 22 years, the meeting has always been acknowledged as an important event for the scientific community, one afforded constant and strong independence. Previous editions have marked important stages in the history of probiotics. In 2007, for example, FAO guidelines for probiotics were defined and officially presented, and in other editions, many international organizations have been involved in scientific areas of the meeting to gather and present position papers, organize sessions, and so on. For the 11th meeting on probiotics, prebiotics, and new foods to be held in Rome on September the 12th to the 14th in 2021, the goddess Ceres was chosen to represent the traditional image of the meeting. Ceres, in the Roman religion, is the goddess of growth of food plants. In fact, the word cereals is not a botanical term, but rather a historical and literary term indicating all food plants producing wheat, rice, buckwheat, quinoa, and amaranth. The production of flour is created to prepare bread and other types of food. When referring to cereal, one must mention the term halobiont. This term was created by the American evolutionist Lynn Margulis in 1991. The idea of halobiont originates from the concept of symbiogenesis, that was developed by Nobel Prize winner for medicine in 1958, Joshua Lederberg. Symbiogenesis indicates a host organism and the microorganisms that live in symbiosis with the host, resulting in mutual benefits. The concept of holobion has a more general meaning, following the identification of a universal presence of microorganisms that are linked in different ways to multicellular eukaryotic organisms. Therefore, holobion and its hologenoma are recognized as one of the fundamental levels for the evolution of terrestrial plants 700 million years ago. In fact, microbiota is a determinant and constructive element in the health and productivity of plants, strictly connected to human health and nutrition. All plant tissues host microbial and endophytic communities that influence their functioning. Thanks to the progress of genomics and metagenomics, we are now able to decipher in extensive detail the components of microbial and endophytic communities. And therefore, we can start understanding the role and interactions between the plant and its host. In the 11th edition, IPA Global, IPA Europe, GPA, Binc Foundation, and Nutrition Foundation will be training partners together with many other associations which are working to improve the program and the topics. Rome is without doubt one of the most beautiful cities in the world, known as the Eternal City, and we are ready to welcome you all here for this upcoming indispensable event.